I wanted to ask you about how your act was born, because you combine stand-up comedy and music.
I was always a funny guy when I was younger. I mean, I was voted class comedian.
Right.
Being funny was just natural. You know, guys have come to me to write comedy for them. And it's just, you know, I always feel when you're doing a show, it's totally boring to just get up and keep singing.
Yeah.
I don't mean to me, I mean to the people sitting there.
Right.
Give them something that they could talk about when they leave. Give them a good time. Be personal. Be like them, you know. Make them feel like you're their friends. Because I consider everybody that comes to my show my friend. I consider people that followed me all those years. And I'm touched, you know. I get letters and my web guy reads me these emails and I've cried listening to some of that stuff, you know, where people say, you touched me, you know, I was in Vietnam and you kept me alive with this magic moment. And
wow.
Different things like that. And being funny is just a part of my show, and I tell stories and I goof around. Of course, at West Hampton, they want me to be nice and not offend anybody.
Right.
I'll be biting my tongue a lot. I'm going to abide by what the rules are and still be funny. The great thing here, Walker, is that at my age, I don't even have to say anything. I'm funny looking already.
Well, you really are very, very funny. I mean, just talking to you, you have such stage presence and impeccable comic timing. And also, like you mentioned, the connection you feel with your audiences. That's such an important element.
You know what I mean? How could you be in the business? I'm going on 50 years doing this. And, you know, people come over, you played my high school prom. And you did this. The scary thing is the people who tell me I played the high school prom are usually in walkers and can barely move.
Right. I mean, do you ever step back and think, how weird is this that I can be in so many different places and touch so many different lives without even knowing it?
That's the greatest thing ever. You know, when people get up every day and hate going to work and hate what they do, there's nothing better than getting out and having people stand up and applaud and laugh. I mean, I wish I had that in my everyday life, you know.
Yeah.
That's the thing that gives you the satisfaction. I love now, I started going to Florida in the winter doing the condominiums where I finally get people who are older than me. And I get these people screaming, oh, you're so hot. And I look, and there's this 95-year-old woman with a German Shepherd who can't see is telling me I'm hot.
Well,
lady, I couldn't be hot if this place was on fire. It's just incredible.
Well,
I'm looking forward to, you know, I've heard so much about this theater, and I'm finally coming there. And after, you know, I'm a Long Island guy now. Was raised and grew up in Brooklyn, but I'm a Long Island guy, and I always said, how come they never brought me to that theater in West Hampton? And now they brought me. So I want to thank the people who sponsored it and hope I sell it out for them. I hope you come in and say hello to me.
I certainly will. And, you know, I have just one more question before we go. I read that you, or for a time, I'm not sure if this is still the case, that you suffered from stage fright, or maybe still do.
Oh, and nobody gets over that. Something that you feel before you go on, it's that anticipation that, what if I'm not good? What if my voice won't work? What if they don't like me? That's what makes you good, because it gives you that source of adrenaline that you need to keep you sharp and to hit the high notes and everything.
Absolutely.
People who aren't fearful, they don't care, and you have to care.
Exactly.
People paid to see you. People took a night out. People used babysitters. People traveled in traffic. You owe it to them to give them 100%.
So is there anything that helps you get into a focused or calmer state of mind before a show?
Are you referring to 10 Valiums?
Yeah, or 10 vodkas, or what, you know, to each his own.
I don't drink.
Uh-huh.
And in fact, you know, I was out with Frank one night when we were doing the movie, Frank Sinatra. He said, Jay, have a drink. I said, I don't drink. He goes, you're fired. You know, he's getting around with me. Well, you need that, and I'll continue having stage fright. And
you'll continue selling out?
I hope so. I hope so.
Yeah.
I got to the age where it's great. When I don't sell out, I blame it on, well, my fans are passing away.
That is a good excuse. That's great. Well, I'm so grateful that you could take the time to talk to us today, and we wish you the best.
Thank you, and I'd like to see you in the theater. And I want to tell you one more thing, Walker.
Please.
Don't ever wake me up again.
I will never call you at this ungodly hour again. And I urge everyone to call the box office, 288-1500. That's the West Hampton Beach Performing Arts Center box office. Or you can purchase tickets online, and that website is whbpac.org. This morning, I've had the pleasure of speaking with the incredible, the powerhouse, Jay Black, the voice, and he'll be performing this Sunday, the 18th of July, at 8:30. Coming up, your BAZ birthdays and your final entertainment update. It's all here, 102.5 BAZ in the morning.